Last May, MW Turvey from Live Survive sent me a lighthouse, and I decided to see if it would be feasible to do FDM with the existing lighthouses. But I played with it, I got a chance to dink with it, but I never really made this video because I just didn't have time. So I'm going to just throw together a little bit of something because people have been bugging me about it recently. So, well, it's not going to be like my normal YouTube videos, but for those who are specifically looking for this video, here it is. So, MW Turvey, the guy who sent this to me, has already done this, and he has indicated that it is well worth my while to do this rather than shortcutting around it. Once I was able to pull off the front of the lighthouse, I needed to interface with the little 4-pin connector doohickey at the bottom. And to do that, there are probably right ways, but I just did it with some tape and some 0.1 inch headers. With the connector together, I tried putting it on the bottom of the lighthouse from the front of the lighthouse. That was particularly difficult, and I don't recommend it for anyone.
Oh my gosh! Oh, no, it was close, though. Nope. Oh, okay, so that was it. There's just two grounds, or the two pins are...
Totally.
Yeah,
huh? And he even says both headers on the right looking in are tied to ground.
Oh, well, okay. Then whack. Oh, man. Now I gotta get it back on.
Gotta do it again.
Black and white, that should be tied.
Should have been live streaming this just to amuse
No, because we don't know if we can publish it yet.
Oh, dear.
We're good.
All right, just don't jiggle that.
Okay, so... Oh, we have to jiggle that, though.
We had a bit of a guide from Alan to help us through things, but we still had a lot of fumbling.
It is not talking.
All right, so we just have a bad connection. Let's pull the assembly out.
Okay, we'll pull the assembly out.
All right, we'll find some tools.
Oh, wow, perfect.
See, am I good at judging those sizes or what?
I just don't understand how this won't destroy the calibration.
Because there's a metal frame that holds the whole thing together.
After finding out that none of my Torx sets actually fit the screws on the lighthouse, I had to do the best I could with getting the connectors in the front.
I don't know what changed, but now it's working!
Okay, good.
We see something coming up. Yeah, buddy! Hello, lighthouse base station. Hey, Adam, check it out. Maybe the other pin isn't on.
So you got it?
Yeah.
Oh, interesting. That's adorable.
Yeah, it's working now.
Oh, you got it?
Yeah, apparently it uses the Minicom standard, so let's run it in Minicom. But this is here. Oh my gosh, look at how fast this thing boots. Okay, watch this.
Wow.
Reboot, enter. That's pretty neat.
Well, it's super simple. I don't see why it would be...
Wow, they were working on firmware as late as May 5th of last year. Wow.
We've gotten updates to the firmware to these, haven't we?
Have we? Oh yeah, we have gotten firmware updates. Okay, that's fair. So now there's a command that I'm supposed to execute to save off the configuration. So the command is EEPROM R04032. EEPROM R04032. Neat. Whoa, hello. Oh, so some of them would be out of sync with each other. That's good.
In addition to almost every parameter being configurable surrounding any of the timing, this means the frequency, the period, the standoff, everything, we found that there were several more modes just ready to go. They just weren't reachable by pressing the button.
Much slower. Much, much slower. This one looks like normal. Oh yeah, that's mode A, okay. Mode B. OC, Ode 7. Can't really tell the difference between Ode 7 and the others, so who knows. Ode 1 is faster. Let's at least make sure we can still read the pulses coming off of it. All I see is pulses. I don't see any, that's interesting. Let's see what we actually see if we dump this data. Mode 4.csv. That's interesting. Some of these pulses are not 1.8 megahertz pulses. Or maybe they are and it's just too... Oh, it's just that it's too long, so it's flipping around. Okay, that's fair. Slave optical master sync slave cable. So right now, 765.053 is this one, so that's 4. So it says 1 on the thing when that says 4. And it looks like we have a pretty good grouping of data. Oh, plus or minus about 2 kilohertz, so that's pretty spectacular.
For FDM, the most important thing would have been to change the carrier frequency. Conveniently, it's just a parameter in the lighthouse.
Param set mode 4 carrier. Yes. Wow. Oh, wow. How low can it go?
Let's try a 900 kilohertz carrier. It's gotten wonky again. Still tracking to 1.51, 1.53.
I didn't get any video of it, but things did get wonky below about 1 megahertz. Thankfully, there's lots more room.
Let's see if it tracks to 2 megahertz. Oh, it definitely tracks to 2 megahertz. So that's about a 20 kilohertz window. That's odd. That would get worse.
I decided to record several carrier frequencies in a single data set, and the results were rather stunning.
I'm going to chalk that up to success today.
I even wrote a program to go through many frequencies on the lighthouse to make sure that there were no dead spots or other problems anywhere. Much to my surprise, the ESP8266 Lighthouse was able to clearly see all the signals between about 1.3 and 3.2 MHz. This is really useful because it would mean that it would be trivial to identify where light is coming from whenever any lighthouse were to hit an ESP8266 receiver. One of the other things I did was drastically reduce the length of the sync pulses. This would allow many more lighthouses to operate in the same area. Unfortunately, I never did find a way to make the sync pulses a different frequency than the sweep pulses, so there'd still be a disambiguation problem.
Adam!
What?
I got the lighthouse out.
Yeah?
It is, ridiculous.
Let me see.
Figured it would have a metal frame, but I guess plastic's not too bad. Easier to injection mold. Though that is a pretty crazy mold. What's this?
Laser.
Oh, it shines down the bore, and then there's a mirror, of course. That's a much better way to do that than anything I thought of. Yeah, that's pretty
what?
Visible.
It takes all that to make the... Look at how much junk is on there, and that's just for a sensor.
There might be a reason. There might be a reason you're not aware of yet. Especially for this one. That junk may be doing something integral to the timing.
Oh, you know what? It may also be doing something that makes it so it can ignore itself, maybe?
What the heck is with the giant capacitors?
Giant capacitors.
For the motors?
I don't know. There is a full-on LPC in here.
How do they sink the heat from these?
I don't see anything. I don't know.
It's a very thin board. I guess they don't produce that much heat. I thought infrared things usually did.
They do.
I like how there's a lot of junk on the other side of the board, too. And look,
so
there's like an unpopular...
Stuff.
Wait, what is this weird copper square thing?
I thought that was...
Oh. Bluetooth, you think?
Yeah.
Okay.
That's what that processor is in there.
Okay. Yeah, that's pretty good.
Man, now I'm afraid to do the thing I wanted to do to this when I wanted to do it.
You wanted to take the board off?
Well, I wanted to go try to change out one component.
Oh. Yeah, good luck with that.
Oh, I see it in there. Oh my gosh, I didn't even know they made them.
I think you could probably take that bottom board off. Okay. Getting it back on will be a little bit tricky with those flexible cables, but you can do it.
It's right.
Because it's this frame here that holds the important bits together. I would definitely avoid moving... Well, actually, that's not doing positioning. It's just doing timing. Okay. Yeah. I guess as long as it's... I don't know. Maybe the position
all
between
it cares
the two...
About it only looks for sync pulses from the other ones.
Yeah, but we're talking about... If it was at the corner of the thing, the sync pulse would happen at a different time relative to this than if it was... Perfectly
no, sync, sync pulse, the flash.
Oh, the omnidirectional.
After I recorded this video, things got very busy for me, so I didn't get a chance to develop this any further. But people continue on with Live Survive and the channel and doing all sorts of interesting projects with it. So I really recommend checking it out, and if any of you guys want to go play with the ESP8266 Lighthouse stuff, I do have all of the stuff up on GitHub for it. I really think FDM could be a viable way to operate this. Another reason why I didn't really pursue this very hard was because it seemed that Valve was going to very shortly be coming out with their CDM lighthouses, FDM meaning frequency division and CDM meaning code division, and I just really kind of lost interest, but who knows, maybe somebody else will be able to take this and run with it.